Hello, everybody. Butstallion's handsome Jack Boy here, bringing you guys the 11th episode of my Borderlands the Pre-Sequel Legendary Weapons Guide. And in this episode, I'm going to be covering the Cato Ninetales. The Cato Ninetales is a legendary laser, and it looks like it has no prefix. I'm not sure what that means, if it means that it has fixed parts. If you guys know, just post in the comments, but as you can see there in the red text, it says, "The cat's out of the bag." That means that the Cato Ninetales is always incendiary, has a decreased fire rate, and fires a beam which ricochets and splits into 3 to 8 beams. Split beams can ricochet twice. Now, really quick, reading under the usage and description section here on the wiki for the Cato Ninetales, it says the Cato Ninetales is a tricky weapon designed for indirect fire. When fired against walls or floors, its ricocheting bolts scatter into many, giving it a very high damage potential compared to other blasters, at the cost of having a somewhat steep learning curve. The scattering beams are also very likely to set off any barrels in the area otherwise. Gladiators taking advantage of Maelstrom can potentially wield this weapon to great effect, particularly against groups of targets. When used properly, it can accumulate 100 plus stacks of Maelstrom nearly instantly, and maintain 200 plus by the time its magazine has been emptied. Its ricocheting effect is also extremely powerful in conjunction with Smite, greatly easing difficulty of hitting a target while in the air. Now, my opinion about the Cato Ninetales. Honestly, this gun is not that bad. It does kind of have a learning curve to it, but once you get around that, you're definitely going to deal some damage. I do like how this gun comes in incendiary, but the fact that it only comes in incendiary is definitely an issue, because that will limit the types of enemies you can use this against. And I found myself running into problems when I was up against enemies with shields. Like, later in this footage, I encounter a couple badasses, right? And both of them, of course, have shields. And I just had the hardest time taking them down. So, at times, I do kind of wish that this gun can spawn with any other element besides fire. But it really isn't that big of a deal. Now, one thing I do like about this gun is the damage. If you can ricochet the shots and, by doing so, successfully hit enemies, you're going to melt faces off, literally. Like, it does some work. Again, it also kind of has a little bit of a learning curve to it. It's actually kind of easy to learn its special effect. All you really got to do is just ricochet the shots off the ground or off the wall or off the ceiling. And obviously, shooting it off the ground is what you're going to be doing most of the time. I tried to shoot it off the wall a little bit in this footage. It didn't turn out that well. Like, doing that will definitely take some time to get used to, but shooting it off the ground, that's really easy. Getting critical hits, on the other hand, now that's also pretty challenging. You just kind of have to hope that when you do ricochet the shots off the ground that it'll connect with their critical hit spot. It might be a little bit of luck based. I actually don't think so though, because when you ricochet the lasers, they split into the same pattern every time. So I think it's more dependent on skill and just whether or not you can ricochet your shots at the right angle. But I think apart from that, guys, that's pretty much going to wrap it up for this video. There's not too much else to talk about when it comes to this gun. It is a lot of fun, it just has a few problems that kind of set it back a little bit. But once you get around those problems, it becomes a pretty good weapon. So, yeah, like I said, that's pretty much going to wrap it up for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe for more, and I'm out of here. Peace!